At this point, for every query that we've written, we've retrieved all the different rows out of our city's table, or whatever table we were working with. In many cases, we want to write a query that is only going to pull out a set of rows that match some kind of criteria. In other words, we want to somehow filter the result set. Maybe we don't want to get every single city. Maybe we only want to get all the cities with an area greater than, say, 4,000. Let's take a look at how we would write a query that would filter out some number of rows in our result set. So back over at PGSQL, I'm going to write out select name and area from cities. And then after the from statement, we're going to put on some filtering criteria. We put on a filter by using the keyword where. And then right after where, we write out our criteria. In this case, we want to try to find all the different cities with an area greater than 4,000. So we would write out area greater than 4,000 like so. I'm then going to run that query, and we'll see that now we only get back two results, Tokyo and Shanghai, and both these different cities have an area greater than 4,000. Let's take a look at how SQL or Postgres is really making use of this query. Getting a good picture or understanding in your head of how this query is interpreted is going to be really key to writing some more complicated queries later on down the road. All right, so here we go. We've got the query we just wrote at the top. We actually also had the area on there, but more or less same thing. Now, you might be tempted to read this entire query from left to right and assume that Postgres somehow executes the query in the same way. It is best to not think of this query as being executed from the left to the right. In other words, don't try to think of this as select from where. But let me show you a little trick, a better way to really understand what is going on with this query. Here's the actual order in which you want to consider these steps being executed by Postgres. The first thing that really happens internally is Postgres takes a look at a data source. It's going to analyze your query, and it's going to see that you are trying to pull in all the different rows from the city's table. After it gets that entire source of data, it then, second, applies that filtering criteria. So it says, for each row, I only want to consider the rows that have an area greater than 4,000. That's going to filter out or remove some rows out of our result set. And then for all the remaining entries or the remaining rows, then we are going to select some number of columns. So we really want to consider from being executed first, then where second, and then the select statement third. So if we apply that over to this diagram, we can imagine that the from statement right here first gets executed, and that's going to give us all the different rows inside of cities. Second, we get the where statement. So we're saying only give us the cities with an area greater than 4,000. And so we can imagine that's going to drop out Delhi, which has an area less than 4,000, and Sao Paulo. Now we're left with just Tokyo and Shanghai. So then third, out of all the remaining rows, we want to only retrieve the name and the area. And so that means give us just name and area, and that is what we ended up as our output back over on that web application. Now, as we move forward, we're going to use this idea of considering which order all these different keywords gets evaluated, because like I said, it makes writing some more complicated queries a lot easier down the road when you are able to actually picture this entire process. All right, so we've taken a look at a very basic application of where, but there are many other ways in which we can use where, so let's continue on and take a look at a couple more examples in the next video.